Hey everyone, welcome back to the Fierce Kittens channel. Today we're going to talk about what machine you need for bag making. So a lot of people ask me, do I need the industrial machine because I have a Juki DU11N or something, and like they're all very mechanical and they're large and they're crazy. And I also have, you know, a fairly high-end Janome machine. I have the M7 Continental. And to be fair, no, you don't really need to have a crazy machine. You just need a machine with some key parts. So yeah, the short answer is no, you don't need an industrial machine. The long answer is a little more complex. So let's go explore that. So what are your basic sewing machine features that you need? Item number one, you need to be able to use a larger needle. And you'd be shocked, some machines really can't handle it because they're smaller and they're meant to be introductory machines. You need to be able to use a size 16 or 18 denim needle. And I don't mean like leather needle, I mean denim. And that's because they have a heavier shank, they're slightly longer, and the eye is open longer as well. This allows the bobbin a little more time to catch that thread coming through from thicker layers. Otherwise, you get like crazy skipped stitches, which we'll go to through in a bit. The second thing you need is to be able to have a longer stitch length. If you can't crank up the stitch length to at least 4 millimeters, you're gonna have a hard time with the thicker layers. You need that extra time, again, just like the larger needle, to be able to dive down through the fabric to the bobbin case and pick up that thread. Again, skipped stitches. You also need a good strong motor. Most of these sewing machines aren't going to actually tell you if they have like a whatever RPM motor on them. The best way to figure out if you're going to be getting a machine with a good motor and even like potentially the entire inside being metal is to look for the HD or strong and tough designation. Most sewing machine brands, particularly Janome, Brother, and Singer, have HD brands underneath their line. So, and actually I will link to a video by another streamer slash YouTuber called Top Custom, and he's actually done a review on a Brother recently that's in their Strong and Tough line. You also need high presser foot clearance. This is actually going to allow you to put higher layers underneath the presser foot. If you don't have this, then what you'll probably run into is the inability to feed your fabric under the foot or to carefully pull the bag away from the machine without it snagging under the foot or possibly catch the needle on the way out. And as you move up into bag making, you like to use more complex materials such as vinyl or maybe even leather. So that's actually a really important aspect of the sewing machine you're gonna choose for bag making. Okay, so what are the kinds of problems that you expect to see in a domestic machine if you know it's not gonna be able to handle your layers, all right? First thing, skipped stitches. The most frustrating thing that you will ever experience is trying to put together several layers of fabric and only to find out that you have gaping holes in the result. Skipped stitches happen when you're using the wrong needle or you have bad thread, your needle is old, or I don't know, maybe you didn't use the right stitch length. And so you're not giving your machine the tools that it needs in order to plow through the fabric. The other thing is, if you're not using the right needle or you're not using the right stitch length, then you'll also have a problem with the needle not being able to make it through all of that stuff. So some machines actually can handle up to like 6 or 8 layers of denim. The problem is people don't know what to use. So let's go through a few of the things that you can do with a domestic machine to help enhance your bag making experience and make those layer problems somewhat disappear. All right, so now you want to fix the problems that you've been encountering with bag making, because glorious bag making, while fun, can also be a trying experience as you start to venture out into using heavier materials like Peltex or Decaville. Sometimes even fleece interfacings can cause a lot of bulk. So one thing that you really need to consider is getting larger needles. As you start getting into the thicker materials, you're going to have to start using a size 16 or 18 denim needle. I highly recommend these. You can actually get them in chrome by Schmetz, and they are considered the professional grade needles. It's not actually required, but if you want to spend an extra buck for a pack, go for it. The other thing is you can increase your stitch length. You can move it, I suggest, somewhere between 3 and 4 millimeters. I usually stick to around like 3.5 when I'm sewing my bags. And I know like most machines, they default to 2 millimeters. You don't need anything that small. And anything, if you're working with a stitch length that small, you're probably gonna perforate your fabric and cause it to rip under pressure. So even if you're using cottons, you probably still want to consider moving up to a 3 millimeter stitch length, if anything, for the safety of the fabric. The next thing you can do is you can beat the crap out of your seams. Yes, I said it, beat the seams. It flattens them down and makes it easier to sew them and to get it through your machine, especially if you have issues with throughput from your motor. Some lighter weight sewing machines really can't handle the layers, and that's really where you're gonna hit your trouble point. But if you hammer the crap out of the seams and then also consider steaming your seams with your iron, mind you, don't actually touch the iron to the fabric, just hover over and steam them. It'll soften them up as well. So hammering to shrink it, steam to make it softer, and that will make it easier for your needle to go through all those layers. You can also pick up a tool called a hump jumper. This will help level out your presser foot so it can easily glide over larger seams. You'll find this kind of seam transition in bags with larger pockets or zippered gussets, so it's a helpful tool to have around. As you can see here, my machine easily handles going from a smaller layer compaction to larger with about 4 layers of vinyl, and this is a domestic machine. Also, regarding bag making tips, sometimes you really aren't gonna be able to sew that seam. For example, the necessary clutch wallet, that last little bit where you have to attach the innards to the flaps, you're not gonna do that in a domestic machine. I'm sorry, Karen, it's not happening. But what you can do is you can work around the problem. It still gives you a professional result and it makes sure that everything is nice and secure. You can use rivets. I highly recommend grabbing a rivet press. Not entirely necessary, but it will make your job a lot easier. It'll make sure that all of your applications of rivets are nice and consistent. Because I don't know about you guys, but when I use the hammer and the little anvil thing to attach a rivet, I get super nervous and I never do it correctly. All you're gonna need is a leather punch and some way to hammer that rivet in there and you're good to go. Rivets are a wonderful alternative for thicker straps, for those crazy last minute connecting seams that aren't really meant to like bind in raw edges, like the necessary clutch wallet. And to be honest, it makes the bag look pretty cool. You get a lot of extra bling from the rivets. There's nothing to be ashamed about that. I have a Juki and I still use rivets only because I actually like the look of it. Okay, so now the hard question. When do you need to go industrial? This is entirely a personal decision for you to make, okay? It really depends on a lot of things. For me, and I'll just tell you my experience, is I got to a point where I wanted to produce things quickly, I wanted to do it efficiently, and I wanted a higher quality. And this isn't to say that a domestic machine is not going to get you there. All I'm saying is that sometimes you're gonna get to a point where you wanna use all, you wanna do all vinyl, everything. You wanna use waterproof canvas for your linings, or you want to use a heavier thread that's meant for larger bags to carry more weight. Trust me, I know. I actually sold a backpack to someone using just plain old cotton thread and it snapped the straps first time she stuffed it. So, which is unfortunate, but these things happen. And there's ways you can get around it, really. But ultimately, the decision has to come down to you. Are you gonna be running a business? Does it make your life easier? Are you happier sewing if you need to get like upgrade to a heavy duty machine? I will say they're large, they're huge. This thing is 200 pounds, right? And that's just the DU1181 anyway. the numbers, whatever. I'll put it in the bottom. Blah. So they're huge. It comes built into a table. It's crazy. But the thing is, like, the price of them is actually not unreasonable. They're anywhere from $1,000 to $1,200 US dollars. And that's with a servo motor. Highly recommend getting a servo motor, but I'll do a video on my Juki at some point. I don't want to go into detail because it's beyond the scope. All I have to say is that, like, if you get to a point with your machine where you've done absolutely everything possible to try to curve those issues that you've been having, you want to run a business, or you just want to enjoy actually making bags, I would highly recommend looking into it. They do take up a bit of space, but I haven't looked back. I do not regret buying my industrial machine. However, this does not by any means mean you have to purchase one of the darn things. You can get along just fine with a domestic machine using the tips and tricks I gave you in this video. Okay? Don't let anybody ever Juki shame you. Okay. All right, thank you very much for paying attention this long. If you did, make sure to subscribe and like, and feel free to come and see me on Twitch. I stream Mondays, Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays starting at 8 p.m. Central. I'd love to see you guys pop by. Thank you.